Hello everyone, welcome again. Now in this video we are going to discuss how we can create a master suite that will trigger all of our JUnit at one shot. So for that I'm going to add one more class inside my source folder. Let me call it as master suite, and I will have all the method inside this suite. Just click on finish. So this is our master suite class. Now in order to make this class to trigger all the JUnit, I need to take the help of two annotation, that is the run with and suite classes. At the rate run with, and it is going to take the argument suite dot class, and you can say that this is a syntax for making any class as a master suite. And after that I need to specify the name of the classes which will be the part of this master suite. So I'm going to use suite classes annotation, and inside that I need to specify the name of classes. So for us it will be testjunit.class, comma, testoracledb.class, comma, testcsv.class, comma, testnegative.class, comma, and testpositive.class. Once this is done, now this particular class has become a master suite which is going to trigger all the class which I specify in the annotation at the rate suite classes. All I need to do is just right click and run as JUnit test. So if I open the console, as you can see that it has triggered all the classes, and if I click on each and every classes, it is going to display me the name of the test case present inside the each class. So in this manner you can use the at the rate run with annotation and suite classes to create a master suite class which is going to trigger all the rest of the JUnit. So let me fail one of the test case intentionally. Let me make it 972 again, and again I will rerun this suite. So if I open the JUnit console, as you can see that all the test cases are getting passed except the test positive, and if I click it I will get the required stack trace. And again I will change the entry to 973, and if I run it once again, it is going, all the test cases will get passed now this time. So as you can see that all the test cases are getting passed. One more thing, let me open the master suite class. Now inside the master suite class we have couple of method. Let me put a sysio over here. I'm just putting the marker so that we will able to see that which method got executed. And I'm using system.err.println so that it will be printed in the red color. And I'm going to put sysio here, saying the name of the, printing the name of the test case. Now I will rerun my master suite class. So if I open my console, as you can see that only the method which is marked with before class annotation and after class annotation, it is getting executed, and rest of the method are not getting executed. So you can say that whatever the class name which is marked with at the rate run with and suite classes, in that only the method which are marked with before class and after class will get executed, and rest of the method will not get executed, irrespective whether it's a test case or whether it's a method marked with have before and after annotation. So there is a one more way of creating suite. All I need to do is just right click, new, other. Now inside the JUnit folder there will be one more type of class file, that is a JUnit test suite. If I select and click on next, it is going to list me all the Java file which is present inside the source folder, and I can select any one of them, or I can select all of them which and this class file will become the part of our suite. So just click on finish. So as you can see that it has created a class name alt_test. It has already added the run with annotation, and it has included all the class file which I required to be a part of this suite. Again, in order to run it, all I need to do is just right click run as do a JUnit. So it has executed, and if you expand this thing, you are going to get the detail about the execution status. So in this manner, you can use take the help of at the return with annotation and at the rate of suite classes to create a master suite which will trigger all the JUnit at the same time. So that's all for this video, and thanks for watching.